Okay, so that's getting the internet set up. Now, what are some of the things that you may be doing if you're a startup business? Well, probably managing tasks via sticky notes. That's a really big one, right? So your tasks are either on a piece of paper, or they're just in your head, or maybe they're written down in Apple Tasks on your phone, but there's no real way of sharing tasks with your team. So one of the most important pieces of technology for a startup business to implement is a shared task management system. And that is a collaborative task management system, so tasks can be delegated to other team members. And what that's gonna cut down on is when you're asking someone to get something done for you and you're employing staff to actually help you get the work completed in a business, it's gonna cut down on you having to follow up so much and ask, is it done yet? 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 Because that's usually what happens in a business when the business owner is doing all the tasks up in their head. And the problem with that is you start forgetting tasks, or you don't know which tasks are important and urgent versus which ones can be left. And what happens is you end up with information overwhelm of trying to remember your tasks as well as your team's tasks as well. The problem for that, if you think about from your staff's perspective, is they're gonna have a problem actually remembering everything that you've told them if there's no documented place for everything that you've delegated to your team. So not only is it important for you to have your tasks managed, but the tasks that you give to your team, you wanna make sure that they are in a proper place as well, which is shared. So for that, we use a task management system. We love a system called Asana because it's free to get started with, super easy to use, works on the mobile, and you can share it with up to 15 people on a team on the free plan to get the basics done on that. And so that is what I would recommend if you are in the Start ecosystem. Now, once you've got some tasks set up, you're also gonna have to start sharing files. We obviously recommend Google Drive for that, but Google has a new feature called Shared Drives. And if you've been using Google for a long time, you may not know that this feature even exists. Now, Shared Drives are a secure repository for your files, and they let you share files with staff inside your business and those outside your business as well, but you control the files. Now, the great thing about this is if you've ever had a contractor or somebody outside your business share a file with you, you may have noticed that you are not the owner of that file. And when someone shares a file with you, they actually have the ability to delete that file because they're the owner of the file. Now, when you use Google Shared Drives inside of Google Drive, that allows you to have someone put a file into a shared drive and you take ownership of that file automatically, which means that once they've shared the file with you, you're now the owner and only you can choose to delete the file if you want to. Now, I've heard so many unfortunate stories of business owners who have had a contractor or a VA or someone outside the business working for them. They've created a bunch of files, they've shared them into your Google Drive, and it looks like they're in your Google Drive, but actually, you don't own the files, and that person then goes and deletes them when they're doing a cleanup of their drive, and bang, everything disappears from your Google Drive. That is very dangerous and can be absolutely devastating to a business. You can't always pick up the phone and call that person. Sometimes it's been a disgruntled employee, or it's been a contractor who's completely disappeared off the face of the earth. So using something like shared drives is going to protect you from that. Super important to get the basics of shared drives and shared folders set up when you are a startup business. But if you're enjoying this content, guys, please drop me a note down below. Say, hey, yeah, Pete, I'm enjoying this, or this is useful. Or if you've got questions, or if you'd like me to repeat any of those certain stages of the business, I'm very happy to repeat. But I'd love to know, where are you watching from? Are you in isolation? Are you free to roam? I'm currently working and living from a camper van at the moment, which is what my interesting decor is here. And so this is my tour where I'm actually testing, can I work on the road? Can I be completely location independent? And I actually happen to be working off mobile internet while I'm traveling, running our business, which is a multi-million dollar organization, nearly 40 employees, all completely from the road from a camper van, which is pretty cool. And so we really, really, truly believe that business owners can achieve this kind of flexibility by using the right technology tools inside your business. So if that's something that is exciting to you, then make sure you check out the rest of this content. So we're gonna jump on to our next one. We're gonna start talking about growth businesses. And here's where things get really exciting. Now, a growth business is a business that has got through that launch and that startup phase. They've got the basics down and they've worked out a viable business model. And this is really where you go through that growth phase. You go from just working on strategies to survive to now strategies for growth and strategies to scale. You're probably going to have things like systemization starting to really take form in the business. You're going to have things like clear position descriptions for your team members. You're going to be hiring team members into specific roles so you can grow them into flourishing roles and high performers in their individual roles. And bit by bit, you're going to be taking more and more hats off and passing them to your team. It's really about getting all the hats off your head and getting them onto team members. However, there are challenges in this stage of business as well. Daniel Priestley calls this the desert. And the desert is about moving from a business that is really a lifestyle business into a performance business. And there are challenges along the way. You're going to have key person risk, where someone you've worked with for a period of time is going to disappear and it's going to cause you a whole heap of pain. You're going to have potential problems where you're not delivering all of the work, or you're not watching all of the work being delivered. And you're going to start to run into challenges with that when someone stuffs something up and you didn't even know that that stuff up was potentially happening, and you didn't even see any of the red flags. You're going to have culture challenges. It's going to be really important for you as the leader of the business to be managing the culture and making sure that that culture is consistent across your team and that you're hiring for culture as well. These are all of the challenges that start to come up in a growth business. And many business owners do not get past this stage. It's interesting that in Australia, according to the Bureau of Statistics, 98.5% of all businesses in Australia have 20 or less employees. And what that says is that if you make it past this stage, if you graduate out of the growth stage, you're in the top 1.5% of businesses, at least in Australia. And so this stage is a really critical stage for getting the systems, the processes, the automations, the software tools, the people in a symbiosis and all working nicely together. So how do we actually do that with our technology tools? Let's start to go through how we might use some of those. Okay, so you'll see here that business processes right now are maybe all over the place, or at least that's where we kind of start off. Businesses in the growth stage tend to find that they're having gremlins, either gremlins with staff, gremlins with technology, gremlins with different systems and tools that they've set up, not quite talking to each other. And things can kind of feel like they're exciting because the business is growing, but also in a bit of flux and having some challenge because you've got issues in the business where things are not running smoothly. And so the most important thing for a growth business is to achieve what I like to call operational flow. And operational flow is where you have tools and people and strategies all coming together to work nicely in one place, in one nice flow, operational flow. And what that means is that you've got tools that are talking to each other, you've got people that are collaborating well and they're competent and confident with the tools that they're using. But on top of that, you've got some automations that are actually reducing the manual data entry and reducing the amount of humans that are required for the business to grow and scale. I run a service business, so I acutely know the challenges of scaling a business and scaling a team when you're primarily selling human labor to get the business done. Now, this can also be applied to a product business or any other kind of business as well, but you would know that as a business grows and scales, quite often inefficiencies can start to pop up. You start to need to think about HR, you start to need to think about more of a focus on culture, you really need to make sure you've got a cost control on the efficiency of your teams. And so something that you should be focusing on as a growth business is, what is the actual efficient output of my team? Can I reduce the amount of human labor required and therefore the capital required for human labor by putting in place some automations or some smarter technology? Can I start to get better visibility of how the business is going on the KPIs? But there can be some downsides to thinking about that as well. As we put in more technology tools, sometimes a growth business will pivot, it'll shift. As it grows, it actually is still refining those business processes, and you're refining the markets that you're addressing, and you're refining the kind of customers that you want to work with, and you're still really proving yourself in a way. So systems and processes that you put in place sometimes can become obsolete in 12 to 18 months. And so that can be a real challenge in this stage of the business. And that's why it can be called the desert, and that's why many businesses do not actually make it out of here. Now, this is the area of business where a lot of problems can come up, and the business owner is the one tasked to actually manage and deal with those problems. Now, where can that be a challenge? Well, quite often the business owner will have mindset challenges around this area, because when you get to the growth stage, you're in a stage where the business is actually growing, but there can be a perception that more growth equals more problems, or more staff equals more problems. And that can actually be a subconscious inhibitor to the business owner continuing to grow the business. And I've literally spoken to thousands of business owners, and you know it when you speak to one of them. They're a bit tired, they're feeling a bit weary from the journey, and they know that they could continue to push harder and grow the business, but maybe they're already working 40 or 50 or 60 hours a week, and so pushing harder doesn't necessarily feel like a great thing to do. Just for what? For more growth? For more staff? For more problems? For more customers that aren't happy? You know, this can be a really challenging area. So how do we fix it? We've talked about all the problems. Let's talk about the actual fixes for this area of the business.